Okay, Claudia Mitchell Mahal. She will be evaluating Greg Miller. I always like to begin with something positive, and I always feel that when people give back pocket speeches, just the fact that they show up is worthy of kudos. So thank you for that. You always bring enthusiasm and energy and no lethargy when you're before us. So I think that's excellent. You also bring confidence and knowledge. As lots of times, no matter what, you always bring history into it. And that's your forte. Obviously, you love it. And you always, at least for me, I think, wow, I'd like to have you as a history teacher, because it seems like you really enjoy. You even said that you do a lot of reading, and you're not just reading because that's your career, and you teach history, but you get enjoyment out of it. And I think that translates, and we can see that. So when you speak and you share that with us, I think we all get that. So I think that was good. I don't think that anybody got a sense that you were unprepared, that you were sort of figuring out what am I going to say next. So that was good. You demonstrated organizational skills because you've been a Toastmaster for a while. You're before people all the time, talking to your students. So that was good. You did rock back and forth. It seems like, as opposed to using the whole stage, you stepped up, you stepped back, you stepped up. It was a little, it wasn't quite, you know, West Coast swing or anything, but. So I think you could use more of the stage. Maybe you could have, as you talked about Alexander and the history part of it, maybe that could have been a certain area over here. And when you got to California and you talked about the yellow-haired girl, maybe that could have been over here. So just something to consider. You also demonstrated Toastmaster skills in using gestures because your hands didn't stay here or stay here, but you moved about. So that was good. I believe, let me see if I have anything else I want to share. I did like the way, as I said, that you talked about the history about Alexander, and then you brought it into something about you. So I thought that was nice that you shared. And I liked the way you ended your speech by giving us hope. You know, sort of saying that you talked about meteors, and then you made the connection that we all are going through different stages of life, and you gave us hope, and it was a positive ending, and that's always good. So kudos to you, and I, of course, look forward to hearing future speeches from you, Greg. Thank you.